What if a future rocket model was designed to not land upright at all? Imagine a Starship descending through the thin Martian atmosphere, then turning sideways, using engines mounted on its sides, and landing like a giant metal airplane? It might sound crazy, right? But surprisingly, this unconventional concept, featuring side-mounted engines and a horizontal landing, has been hotly debated in the aerospace sector. The real question is, could it actually work, or would it break every rule of rocket design we currently understand? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. Have you ever wondered why Elon Musk is so concerned about landing legs? The answer is simple. Landing legs add weight. Landing legs complicate the structure. Furthermore, landing legs introduce more potential points of failure. However, the problem is that without landing legs, the rocket has no means to stabilize itself upon landing and will simply fall over. Therefore, initially, landing legs seem very important. But Musk disagrees with this thinking. While others viewed legs as the only solution, Musk went far beyond convention and designed an incredible concept, a giant metal tower with two robotic arms that could actually catch the boosters mid-descent, indeed, Mechazilla. Now, that's a fantastic method for a launch on Earth. However, this raises a more important question. Is something like this feasible on the Moon or Mars? Let's break this challenge down to its basic concept. How could Starship land safely on another celestial body if legs weren't a viable option? In the early stages of Starship's design, Musk suggested a highly innovative approach. Instead of conventional legs, why not utilize the spacecraft's structure as a landing platform? His idea involved Starship landing vertically and then tilting gently just before impact, using a deployable composite landing surface to distribute the load and maintain stability. SpaceX even included this idea in their application for NASA's human landing system, although NASA wasn't entirely convinced. They preferred the safer and more traditional approach of vertical landing with legs, especially for crewed missions. However, the unconventional horizontal landing concept persisted and gained traction online. The aerospace community embraced it, producing many imaginative variations. One popular video even depicts a Starship featuring four side-mounted Raptor engines intended to allow for orientation changes during descent for a smooth horizontal landing. So, what makes this sideways or horizontal landing approach so appealing? For starters, it spreads the forces experienced during landing across multiple sections of the rocket's sides. You could think of it as giving the rocket a wider base for stability. That added balance helps prevent it from tipping over upon landing. There's another interesting benefit, too. By placing the engines along the sides, you can lower the rocket's center of gravity. This is similar to how a sports car maintains stability during sharp turns by being positioned lower to the ground. In concept, this configuration reduces the rocket's instability and makes it simpler to stabilize during landing if constructed appropriately. However, this is a capability that bottom-mounted engines simply do not possess. Conventional rockets exert force from the underside directly. Consequently, all landing forces are funneled through a singular, narrow point. The landing gear must endure all the impact, manage the entire weight, and maintain the rocket's vertical position. This is a considerable challenge, particularly on planets like Mars, where the rocket must contend with atmospheric drag and position itself correctly while descending. Yet, this raises an important question. Can this lateral landing strategy actually work? Is it within Starship's capabilities? Some believe it is, and their logic is quite sound. They reference the hinge points of Starship's flaps, those robust, large joints that secure the substantial aerodynamic flaps on both sides. While Starship passes through Mars's sparse atmosphere, it faces lateral forces exceeding 400 tons at those hinges. Although this is significant, those joints are designed to withstand it. Therefore, since those hinge points can already manage substantial side loads, why not place engines on them? Theoretically, SpaceX could attach smaller Raptor engines or thrusters at these hinge points, leveraging the current structure to endure landing pressures. This is an unconventional notion, yet it is not unattainable. Moving this idea to the lunar environment simplifies matters even further. The Moon lacks a true atmosphere, meaning Starship would not encounter substantial lateral forces during its descent. For this reason, engineers propose that the lunar variant of Starship, especially the one intended for NASA, known as HLS, might not require significant reinforcements. Its present design might be sufficient for landing with just some minor adjustments. Furthermore, side-mounted engines are not merely a product of science fiction. Analogous systems have existed before, albeit on a smaller scale. Take the space shuttle, for instance, which featured 6 small vernier thrusters for orientation adjustments in space. Additionally, NASA's Space Launch System incorporates a combination of large main engines mounted at the bottom and smaller auxiliary thrusters distributed around the vehicle for control. However, there is a significant drawback. The side-mounted engines and thrusters we've discussed have only functioned as ancillary systems, rather than being responsible for the main lift or landing of a spacecraft. There's a valid explanation for this limitation. When engines are situated on the sides, they induce asymmetric pressure on the rocket's structure. Instead of pushing directly upward, they exert force at an angle, causing the rocket to flex slightly. It is similar to applying pressure to one side of a ruler and causing it to bend. This bending leads to what engineers identify as structural stress. To accommodate this, the rocket's frame must be constructed with added strength, which often results in increased weight. The challenges do not end here. The fuel delivery system and management controls for side-mounted engines become significantly more complex. You have to orient the fuel differently, handle thrust vectoring innovatively, and maintain the rocket's balance during a sideways launch. This adds another layer of complexity and increases the likelihood of failure. During takeoff or landing, this lack of balance creates substantial difficulties. If your engines aren't pointed vertically, maintaining stability during descent becomes much more challenging. A small error can cause the rocket to tip over. Ultimately, the traditional setup, with bottom-mounted engines, remains the norm. It's simple, validated, and works effectively. However, that doesn't mean the concept of a side-thrust Starship isn't appealing. Imagine a future version of Starship equipped with side-mounted Raptor engines. Sounds wild, but also quite impressive, doesn't it? What do you think? Should SpaceX or other companies explore this possibility in the future? Share your thoughts in the comments below. I'd love to hear your ideas on innovative landing technologies that might be feasible for future space missions. Not only are side-mounted engines a popular option, but horizontal landing concepts in general are less popular. Many engineers and space enthusiasts agree that while it may seem sophisticated, its drawbacks likely far outweigh its advantages. The main issues are mass, complexity, and practicality. Let's address mass first. Performing a horizontal landing requires additional equipment. This includes reinforcements to withstand the bending stress of the side engines and more systems to control thrust from various orientations. However, it doesn't stop there. Horizontal landings often require additional fuel tanks, which add weight until deployed at the end of the mission and are much heavier than aerodynamic flaps. This is primarily due to the rocket requiring more fuel to regulate its descent and maintain a tilted or inclined position like an airplane before landing. Unlike a vertical landing, where the rocket fires its engines directly downward to reduce speed, a horizontal landing relies on wings and control surfaces to glide and decelerate over a longer distance. This means the aircraft remains airborne for longer periods and requires fuel to keep the engines running or to adjust its alignment during the glide. Furthermore, horizontal landing configurations generally incorporate larger wings and control elements, which increase space usage and weight. As a result, larger fuel tanks become essential to ensure sufficient fuel for long and complex landing approaches. Furthermore, from an engineering perspective, facilitating such a design requires substantial structural improvements to the point where, when feasible, creating an entirely different vehicle may be a more effective solution.